So my association with the India Foundation for the Arts began really about 10 or 12 years ago when I was working on a new theatre play, which later was called 1456 Polyester 84. It was intended to be a retelling of the history of the mill workers. And it was a difficult project because it involved a fair amount of research over 7 months. Actors had to get attuned to the subject to understand what kind of character they were playing. Setting it up was a difficult task, and we were very short of resources. But we were very sure that we wanted to do it the way it needed to be done. So I wrote to the IFA for support, and they were very, very forthcoming. And you know, the play then went on to run for about three and a half years, and we did performances all over the country, right through Maharashtra. And it's interesting, it wasn't as though the quantum of support was very large. It was the fact that it happened at the right time, and it also brought home to me that small interventions in the art actually make a huge impact, because they allow you as an artist to take that little bit of risk which otherwise you'd be too afraid to, because you know, a financial loss would break your back. A few years later, they supported the research for another project that was again very research intensive. We worked on it for almost a year, gathering material, a play called Sex, Morality and Censorship, which, as the name suggests, worked with the whole idea of censorship in the theatre and in society at large. So the association with IFA has been through grant making for upcoming productions, but also I've been on various projects of theirs as a friend, as an advisor, as a consultant, projects that have to do with building theatre resources for the theatre community, projects that involve looking at arts proposals from other practitioners and helping the IFA come to decisions about, you know, what is the value of this project. So the association has been long, and really the IFA is more a friend rather than an arts foundation. And I think that kind of relationship between funding organization and artists, which is so much more equal and not a patronage kind of based relationship, is very, very important. The arts of all kinds in this country, our country, survive without any real support, funding. Most artists play a dual role. They're almost entrepreneurs and then artists. So we as artists, we find the funding, we think of an idea for a play or for a piece of art, we execute that, and then after that we have to work very hard to get it out into the public domain so that we can share our work with people. The environment is a fairly difficult environment. Sense that in the absence of state support or any other kind of support, the artist is really left to fend for himself in this. And the only reason why artists do it is because there is a passion for what they do and a great desire to share their work and their vision of the world. Support for the arts from society is critical for the health of society. And it needn't be very large amounts of money. Small interventions make a huge impact. It's almost the same as what happens when income generation program or to a health program. Small interventions change people's lives. And the appeal really here is that if you can, in some way, in your own way, an individual, support the arts, I'm sure that it will make a huge difference, not just to the artist who gets that support, but to society at large. I've had personally a very, very good association with the arts, and I really value their existence and the work that they put in. And please accept this as a personal request to support the India Foundation.